In this tutorial, we'll show you how to configure advanced sales forecasting in Oracle Sales Planning Cloud. As the administrator, you'll need to complete each of these steps to set up advanced sales forecasting. In this example, I've already created an application and enabled the advanced sales forecasting features I want to use. Now let's configure the application by completing the rest of the steps. First, go to the configuration page to configure time periods. You set the current fiscal year, period, and week, and a planned start year of either current or next year. Updating these settings is part of your regular forecast maintenance, and changes automatically roll your forecast forms and business processes forward. If you enabled rolling forecasts, you can also select the planning frequency and the number of periods to use. Rolling forecast period options vary by planning frequency. I'll select a monthly planning frequency and save the changes. Next, import metadata. You can import multiple dimensions at the same time on the application page. In this example, advanced sales forecasting is set up to use the dimensions territory, accounts, product, and sales channel. When you create an import, you can select files for each dimension. You can choose to automatically refresh the database if the import is successful. Go to the Jobs page to ensure that the imports and database refresh were successful. Next, let's import historical actual data to form the foundation for the forecast. I'll import a comma delimited file in a planning format. Note that you can also import data through data management and APIs, and you can automate imports using EPM Automate. I loaded the historical actuals for the remaining years, as well as January FY19 actuals. Next, set the user variables that drive the context of the dashboards, forms, and calculations. Now let's prepare the forecast. First, run the Prepare Actual rule set. Apply the rule set to all the historical periods and years you've loaded. Prepare Actual processes all the historical data, aggregates it through the hierarchy in the reporting cube, and makes it available for predictions. The more historical data you load, the more accurate your predictions will be. Next, run the Forecast Prep rule set to copy actual results for the historical periods and years you've loaded into the forecast scenario. Finally, run the RPT totals to GSP rule. Even if your data is loaded at a detailed level, this rule copies aggregated totals from the reporting cube into the forecast cube to allow for predictive forecasting at the territory level. Run these three rules for the periods you load whenever you import new actual data. Now that advanced sales forecasting is configured, sales managers can begin creating forecast predictions, adjusting forecasts, and analyzing forecast data. Thanks for watching.